The voters in the state voted to prevent kids from smoking. So we figured, let's go for it. Let's prevent kids from smoking. We tried humor. We had camels laughing before a camera, making a parody of the brand of camel. We had Roger Clemens in a Red Sox uniform, you know, saying don't smoke, and Pedro Martinez. And kids turned to us and said, you know, if you think this is a serious problem, you got to treat it seriously. And so we came back and said, you know, maybe we got to tell real stories about real people talking about empathy and about communicating real risk. Humor, no. Role models, no. What you have to do within your messaging is you have to link your target audience with the real people, real stories, negative emotion. So we needed a face. We needed a face to make this work. So Pam became not only our face, but she became our poster child, fighting against cancer and emphysema and other tobacco-related diseases. We did a single Pam ad, and we found that to work well as part of our truth campaign. You want to use real people, tell stories, and make people engage. And the tragedy with Pam is Pam went in rejection for her emphysema. Pam got back on a transplant list. Yet she got high up on the list, developed a bronchial infection, couldn't go back to the ER, because if she did, she'd fall on the bottom of the list. She only had 6 weeks to live, and she died on her driveway with her two children, Amanda and Crystal, holding her hands. And so we then retagged the ads, and that's probably the most manipulative thing I've ever done in my life. But I figured, hey, you gotta do it because you don't wanna have any more Amanda and Crystals holding their mom's hands on driveways. So for us, we think the Pam strategy was probably the most effective strategy that we executed. The only problem with that strategy is it probably resulted in tens and tens of thousands of people quitting smoking, but probably not saving the life of the most important person, and that was Pam.